Mr. Wendy, this is my friend Valerie, and this is my friend Stevie. Keeping your pet's nails well-groomed and short is certainly something that's important to just general husbandry and just keeping them in good condition. Having a cat or a dog with really, really long nails could certainly damage your furniture, especially if it was a cat, could even scratch you unintentionally. And if the animal's nails are too long, they could get caught up on objects or even, in worst case scenario, grow into the pad, curl into their paw pad, which can cause injury to your pet. For a very long time, the only real option to keeping your pet's nails short would be to just traditionally clip them with a nail trimmer. But nowadays, there are other products available that are actually electric nail grinders, which are constructed and made to blunt the nail without actually cutting it, making it dull. And this type of device could potentially be good or a good option for you and your cat or dog as far as grooming their nails goes. So with the help of Stevie today, I'd like to go through the steps of how to get your animal used to using an electric nail grinder. There are many available. This is the one we're using today. This is the Pedipaws device. Basically, we're going to go by step by step, and I do want to reiterate that number one, this is Stevie's first time ever having this done, so we'll have to see how it goes. And number two, this is a very gradual process with a lot of animals. You can't just expect to have it work initially. You have to give them a lot of time to get adjusted to this technique, and we're certainly going to go through that with you today. So what you want to do is have you and your pet in a comfortable place. We have a cat today, Stevie, so Stevie likes to be wrapped in a blanket or a towel. It's actually very good for calming. And we have Valerie here, since Valerie is Stevie's owner, to keep Stevie as comfortable as possible. The first thing you'd want to do is just bring the device near your animal. Make sure you spend enough time putting the device near them, and once they seem to not be bothered by that, you can go ahead and turn the device on, just so they can hear the noise. You may need to go through this several times before actually clipping or filing down the nail. So Stevie actually seems to be pretty good with the noise, so we are going to go ahead and try to just file down a couple of nails and see how it goes. So Valerie's actually helping me by holding up the paw, so you'll need to do that. Get the paw in a good position, and with a cat, you're going to want to retract out the nail. Make sure you have a good angle on it. I'm going to turn on the device. There is a hole right there. You can see the hole in the yellow tip. That's where you would want the nail to be, and there's actually a grinder within that that's going to grind the nail. So we're going to take it. We're just going to go around in a circular motion. You just want to do that. They say no more than 2 seconds to start for each nail, because you don't want to grind the nail back too far, because if you did that, you might endanger or run into the problem of hitting the quick, which is where the nerve and blood supply lives, and we would not want to do that. Good boy, Stevie. Good boy. So as you can see, Stevie's actually a wonderful candidate to use the Pedipaws or an electric nail grinder, because he didn't seem to mind it at all, and granted, this is actually his first time doing it. So what you would want to do is repeat all of these steps as much as necessary to get your animal used to it. And each time they do a little bit of good work and they're cooperative for any of the steps, you always want to positively reinforce them. We have some treats for Stevie, some pats and some kisses. Let them know that they're doing a good job. See if this would work out for you and your pet. So that's pretty much the basics of how to use an electric nail grinder. Again, there's many different types available. And if your animal enjoys having this done and does not mind it, then it would be a great option for you as far as keeping their nails well-groomed. If not, there's always the option of traditional nail trimming. I hope you found this helpful, and thank you very much.